Hello dear friends, welcome to another video of the Never Do Through the GUI What You Can Do Through the CLI channel. I am Vangelis Prokopiou and you are watching Drupal Taxonomy Term Migration, the quick and easy way. Today I will show you, as the video says, a quick and easy way to migrate taxonomy terms without executing a regular migration, but of course this applies only to specific situations which I will describe. So let's go here. I have a site here which has some taxonomy terms, as you can see, and here I have a brand new site. Let's go to the taxonomy vocabularies, taxonomy. We only have tags, we will use this one, and right now it is empty. So let's say that we want to transfer these taxonomy terms from this site or any other site to this new site. The classic way is to create a migration, but in case these taxonomy terms are not complicated and you are only interested in the name of the taxonomy term and in not in other fields of the taxonomy term, then a very easy way is the one that I'm going to describe right now, which is this one. First of all, we will gather all these taxonomy terms with a little JavaScript. Let me bring this here and go to the console. And if we inspect this, we will see that it has this class. So we can say here, this is the class. Let me zoom in. Okay. So we can say that we want to create an array from document get element by class name, and the class name will be this one. Okay, we have the terms, so the next thing we want to do is to map and element dot inner text, and this command, as you can see, will return all the names of the taxonomy terms. So we can copy this thing, copy. Now we have all these names, and the next step that we have to do is to go to the new site, the one that we want to migrate to. This is the new site. I have it opened here in PHP Storm, and the easiest way is to open an existing module. We will use a core module, which we will revert, of course. We will not edit it permanently. For example, I know that the update module implements the cron method, so we just want a module that implements the cron method. And what are we going to do here? We will say that our terms equal to this array that we copied, and then we will create a for each loop, and we will say that for each terms as term, what do we want to do? We want to create. We want term create. Come on, term. We want the taxonomy term entity. It's not working for me, so I will copy paste the command from my notes here. The command is, of course, the taxonomy entity create, and the create accepts an array with the stuff that we want to provide for every taxonomy term. So of course we want to provide the name, which will be the term in this case, and we want to provide the vocabulary ID, which in this case is going to be tags for this demonstration. And the next thing we have to do is to run cron. So we will come to our terminal here, and what we will say is dras cr and dras cron, and if everything goes according to plan, here is the site, we have no terms. Let it execute. Okay, it executed without any errors. So if we come here and refresh the page, let's see what happens here. Do we have the terms? No, we don't. Why don't we have the terms? Why don't we have the terms? Terms equals to this. Yes, we did not call save on this. On each term, we have to call save. Let's try again. Let's come to the browser. Let's refresh. Okay, and as you can see, we have all the taxonomy terms migrated from this site. Yes, you may say that, okay, we created the terms, but we can't save them and we can't recreate this migration because we don't have a proper migration. But what we can do instead, we can use this module, which is the structure sync module, and we can export these taxonomy terms to our configuration. And this is exactly what we are going to do now. We will say dras export taxonomy, let's see the git status, nothing, so we will say now dras configuration export, and now we have the configuration. And if we search to verify, for example, that we have this string, let's search for this string rg making off, and we will search in config. And as you can see, indeed, we have this YAML which contains all our taxonomy terms, and we can verify it by running a cat command here. And as you can see, we have all these taxonomy terms exported to our configuration. And indeed, we will verify it with another way. So we have a clean repo here. And we will add another term, which we will call, for example, let me zoom in, foo, and we will save. And now if we say again dras et export taxonomies, and again DRAS configuration export. We see that we updated this file, and if we run a git diff, you will see the new taxonomy term with the name foo that we just added. So to recap, if we just want to migrate taxonomy terms that we are just interested in the names and not in other complex fields, we can extract them with JavaScript with this command. We can copy paste, and then we can go to any module that implements the update cron hook, and we can run this loop for all of these terms. For all of these terms, the terms will be created, we will revert the module, and then we can export the terms to our configuration. So in the next configuration import, we will have these terms available. This is all the stuff that I wanted to share with you in this video. I hope that you find it informative. I hope that you also like the video. If you do, you can comment, like, and subscribe by clicking the penguin that you will see on your screen. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.